Both teams know something special about each other right now. They know that a parity has been reached. The expansion team has grown up and doesn't concede victory as fast as it did in the old days. And the established Bruin team knows something, too. They know they can't count their chickens so fast anymore because there's new respect on the ice for this young Buffalo club. It's something tangible, something that almost shows in the players' faces. New confidence from a Sabre team that seems to be skating towards greatness. They move with added grace, and each attack on the goal is carried out with speed and precision. They swarm around in the Boston zone, passing the puck around to each other, digging for it to keep control of the action and taking shots at Gilbert from all angles. Pleasing Bruins know now they're in a game. They've had years of experience playing at the top, facing the pressure of winning, and they recognize Buffalo's energy as the same kind they had when they were out to prove themselves. And once again, it's Bobby Orr who stirs them up. Action moves from one end of the rink to the other in an almost continuous pattern of attacking and defending, neither team getting an edge and neither team giving one. And finally, the tension snaps as tempers flare, and the Boston goalie comes out of his net to fight for the puck. It's a costly mistake as he trips Sabre Jim Lorenz, and Boston is called for a two-minute penalty. Esposito is furious, claiming he was tripped at the other end where no penalty was called, and referee Van Helemont can count on one less Christmas card next year. Boston again must defend against Buffalo's power play, and that means watching a lot of guys who can score a lot of goals. It also means that sometimes the Bruins' offense is their best defense, and they break in on Buffalo goalie Jerry Duchart, who makes a fine save on Esposito, and then Dallas Smith as the action swings back the other way again. But the second period ends with the teams still tied 1-1. The last 20 minutes of this hockey game are played as if both teams were already in the Stanley Cup Final. They each know that the go-ahead goal now is as important as any that's been scored all year. And the Bruins of Boston and the Sabres of Buffalo leap into a whirlwind. With only half the period left, the marvelously gifted Gilbert Perreault gets the goal that puts Buffalo ahead 2-1. Bobby Orr talks about it.
They're a great hockey club. The French Connection line, incredible incredible hockey line. Gilbert Perreault, I think, is one of the finest hockey players I've ever seen. The way he handles the puck and the moves he puts on some defensemen and forwards, including myself. He's embarrassed me, but that line, it's a great line. And they've just got everything going. They're playing very well. They're getting pretty good goaltending. If they can get good goaltending, they're going to be tough, because they're a good hockey club.
And now the Bruins are in an unfamiliar position for them, trailing the Sabres as the minutes in this game tick away. They put their best passers and the best shooters on the ice for their final surge, and Buffalo's defense stiffens, closing itself into a tight shell around their goalie, giving him room to see each shot. 2 minutes to go as the Sabres storm briefly into the Boston zone. Gilbert coming up with a pair of super saves to keep the Bruins alive, and once again they attack towards the Sabre net. In a desperate attempt now to salvage a tie, Boston replaces its goalie with an extra skater, and the risky move leaves their net wide open. The Bruins must win the faceoff to control the puck, but it bounces around from stick to stick, and Buffalo shoots it up ice. Rookie Danny Gare comes out of nowhere and provides the finishing touch to a big Buffalo victory. Becomes the sixth Sabre to score 30 goals in one season, another new NHL record. And the win pushes Buffalo ahead of Montreal and Philadelphia in the league standings and adds more proof that these young Sabres have pushed their dream that started in October that much closer to the Stanley Cup championship in May. They believe they can do it, and after tonight, they aren't the only ones.